morning, madam. In the series of lectures of BSc third year, paper number 9, probability distribution. This is second lecture of Pareto distribution. In first lecture, we will see what is mean. So, mean of Pareto distribution is alpha beta divided by beta minus 1. Mode, since Pareto distribution, the range of Pareto distribution, that is the range of x, depends on one of the variables, that is alpha, and hence we cannot find the value of mode, and hence we can find the value of mode by this graph, and the value of mode is alpha over here. Okay, now let me find what is the variance of Pareto distribution. So by using the formula for variance, the formula for variance is, what is the formula for variance? Expectation of x square minus expectation of x bracket square. Okay. Now, expectation of x square, by using the formula expectation of x square is integration over the range of x square fx dx. Now, replace the value of range as well as fx. So, the value of range is also alpha to infinity x square. And in the fx, I have the constant term as beta into alpha raised to beta. Beta alpha raised to beta. Okay. And in the denominator, we have x raised to beta plus 1. So over here it is 1 divided by x raised to beta plus 1 dx. Okay. Over here we only replace the range of x as well as the value of fx. Okay. Now, let me find the integration of this as, so expectation of x square, now this is equal to beta alpha raised to beta alpha to infinity, the powers are as x raised to minus beta minus 1 plus 2, so we get this as x raised to minus beta plus 1 d. Now the integration of this is beta alpha raised to beta x raised to minus beta, or x raised to 1, integration of x raised to 1 minus beta is, we have the integration of x raised to minus beta plus 2 divided by, in the denominator the same term is present as minus beta plus 2, and the range is alpha to infinity. Okay, so we get this as beta alpha raised to beta divided by, we can take the term minus beta plus 2, which is constant, and we can put the values of x as infinity, we get this as 0. And if we put the value of x as alpha, we get this as minus alpha raised to minus beta plus 2. Okay, so let me simplify this. So so suppose we can write this as c, beta is minus, the minus term. So beta alpha raised to beta, then we have the powers of alpha as alpha raised to beta, then minus beta plus 2, and in the denominator if you have common and minus sign, then beta minus 2, and then it comes as beta alpha raised to alpha square only divided by beta minus 2. So this is my expectation of x square. So to find the variance, we have variance of x is nothing but expectation of x square minus expectation of x bracket square. So this is equal to, now expectation of x square is this, that is beta alpha square divided by beta minus 2. Okay. And the expectation of x is c, this term, that is alpha beta divided by beta minus 1. So this is minus alpha beta divided by beta minus 1 square. So this comes as beta alpha square divided by beta minus 2 minus alpha square divided by beta minus 1 square. So we can simplify this as, the common term is beta alpha square. So we have this can be written as, if we have beta alpha square as common term, then we get this as 1 divided by beta minus 2 minus we have from this we have beta beta minus 1 square. Okay, now this is nothing but if we can have the we can solve this bracket. Now to solve the bracket we have see we can solve this bracket as beta alpha square in the bracket. I have beta minus 1 square minus beta beta minus 2 and in the denominator I have the term as beta minus 2 beta minus 1 square. Taking the term of C, beta alpha square is a constant. This comes from the bracket. And in the bracket we have beta minus 1 square minus this beta and beta minus 2 in the numerator. And in the denominator I have beta minus 2 beta minus 1 bracket square. Okay. Now let me simplify the numerator over here since denominator is doesn't simplify. So beta minus 2 denominator I have beta minus 1 square and solve this square term as beta square minus 2 beta plus 1 minus I have this as beta square minus 10 plus 2 beta. Okay, so what remains which was in the bracket observed? So beta square get cancelled. Again minus 2 beta get cancelled. I have only the remaining with me is plus 1. So in the bracket I have plus 1. So radius of x is beta alpha square divided by beta minus 2 into another bracket beta minus 1 bracket square. So that is the radius of palette of distribution. Now by using the first, we can now the next point is we need to find the skewness by using mode. Skewness by using mode. So the formula for skewness by using mode is mean minus mode divided by SD. Mean minus mode divided by SD. So over here the value of mean is alpha beta divided by beta minus 1. Alpha beta divided by beta minus 1 minus mode is alpha divided by SD, that is square root of this term, isn't it? So square root of this term is beta alpha square divided by beta minus 2 beta minus 1 bracket square and square root of this whole term. Okay, I can take the square root of this whole term. So, after solving this, if we solve the terms, we get this as C. We get this as alpha beta minus alpha beta minus 1 divided by beta minus 1. And denominator add this. For our simplification, we can't solve this denominator. Okay, so denominator 1 divided by square root of beta alpha square divided by beta minus 2 beta minus 1 bracket square. Okay. Now, see, over here alpha beta minus minus plus alpha. Okay. So the only term in the numerator is alpha beta minus alpha beta plus alpha divided by beta minus 1. So only term in the numerator is alpha. So alpha divided by beta minus 1. That is the only term which I have in the numerator. Okay. So the value is alpha divided by beta minus 1 whole divided by square root. Now from the square root we can take some terms out of the square root. As since alpha square we can take this as alpha and divided by since beta minus 1 square is there. We can take beta minus 1 also. And hence in the square root I have only term as beta divided by beta minus 2. Getting the denominator C. Since we have square root, okay? Instead of square root, I can take all the square terms outside the square root. So over here alpha divided by beta minus 1. Whole bracket square, isn't it? So alpha square comes as alpha divided by beta minus 1 square comes as beta minus 1 only. So alpha divided by beta minus 1 square root of of beta divided by beta minus 2. Okay. Now, after simplification, we get this as 3. In the numerator term and in the denominator term, the term is same. We get this as 1 divided by square root of beta divided by beta minus 2. Okay. And suppose we take this as, we can invert the square root. And after inverting the square root, we get this as beta minus 2 divided by beta. That means we can write this as also 1 minus 2 divided by beta. 1 minus 2 divided by beta. So, your skewness depends on the value of beta. Your skewness depends on the value of beta. That means if the value of beta is less than 2, then this gives me negative. That is, this gives me the value which is suppose 2 minus 1. Okay. So, which is less than 2. So, 2 minus 1 gives me minus 2. And then 1 minus 2 is minus 1. So, square root of minus 1. That means it is negative value. And hence it is negative skewed. And if beta is greater value, then we get positive skewed data. Suppose beta is 4. Then what we get? 2 divided by 4. That means it is half. And 1 minus half is half, which is positive half. Okay. And then we get positively skewed distribution. Okay. So, depends on the value of beta, the distribution is positively skewed or negatively skewed. If the value of beta is less than or equal to 2, less than 2, only less than, not equal to. If the value is less than 2, the parameter distribution is negatively skewed. And if the value of beta is greater than 2, greater than or equal to 2, then the parameter distribution is positively skewed. Okay. So in the parameter distribution, from the beginning, what we see, we can see what is mean, then the definition, then what is variance, then mode, and the skewness.